In this video, we're going to learn how to use the if formulas in Excel. And the if formulas are basically Excel's version of if-then. So we're going to set parameters within the formulas. And if those parameters are met, then we'll need to let Excel know what result we want. And if the parameters are not met, we'll have to specify that result as well. And the formulas go from your basic simple if to a little more complex. So to walk you through what those could look like, I created this imaginary sales report that has just salesperson, what items they were selling, and how many dollars they sold. Then to figure out their commission, we'll need to know that they need to sell minimum $40,000 to get a 10% commission, $50,000 for a 15% commission, and then after $50,000 of sales, they'll get a special award. Anything less than 40, they get nothing. So, to get started with the simple basic formula, we just want to know, does this salesperson even qualify for a commission? Yes or no? So, to do that, we'll type equals if, open parentheses, and we need to reference for this the dollar sold. So, we'll say if D4 is greater than or equal to $40,000, then we'll say yes. And if not, it'll be no. Now, notice how I'm using quotation marks. That's because this is text. If you try to type text in these formulas, I'm missing a quotation mark here, and you don't use the quotation marks, Excel gets a little confused and you'll get an error. So we already know from looking at this that the first person, Jamie, qualified for a commission, so she'll be receiving one. So I just want to copy this down. I'm going to do a paste special just because I don't want to ruin my formatting and paste as formulas. Then we want to know, did they qualify for a special award? Again, $50,000 or more worth of sales is a special award. So we'll do another basic formula of equals if, again, referencing dollars sold, equals if, referencing dollars sold is greater than or equal to $50,000, then if it is, then our response will be special award. And if it's not, this time we just want to leave it blank. So I'm going to type my quotation marks, a space, another quotation mark, and then I'm going to close my parentheses. And I'm going to copy this down again and paste formulas. And we see that only two salespeople, Emerson and Jamie, receive a special award. Now, you can also use the if formula by having it look at different things. So, and or. So in the or formula, you can give it certain parameters, and at least one of those parameters needs to be met for your result to be true. And if it's not, and if none of those are met, then it's false. With the and, everything has to be met. So to illustrate this so you can see what I'm saying, we need to know who sold food. The only food items here between shirts, pillows, pants, bread, and eggs are bread and eggs. So what we'll do is we'll type equals if, open our parentheses, and we'll type or. Open our parentheses again, and you see how our formula changes. So now we're in the OR formula, and we need to type what those logical values are. So we need to know if item sold, so in this case cell C4, equals to, and I'm going to put in quotation mark, bread. Then I need another logical value here for Excel to look for. So if C4 equals to eggs. I need quotation marks. Then I'm going to close this parentheses. And when I do that, this changes again. And now I'm back to the if formula. So if this is true, make sure to have that comma here. If that's true, then the answer will be yes. If it's not true, the answer will be no. And again, this doesn't need to be case sensitive. I've typed it in lowercase. It's uppercase here. And as I reference this cell, when I copy the formula down, the reference will stay with it. So we see here that the only two yeses Our buddy and newbie, they were selling bread and eggs. So, an example of the AND formula, it's pretty much the same as the OR, except all of the parameters need to be met. But in this case, we want to know who received a commission and an award. And I know this is already pretty much illustrated here, but I want to show you how to write the formula. So to do that, to figure this out, what we'll do is we'll type equals if and then we'll open our parentheses and we'll say if cell E4 equals to yes. And then again, if cell F4 equals to special award. Those are parameters. And if both of those are met, then we'll type in hooray. And if those are not met, this time we're just going to leave it blank. So I'm going to do my quotation marks, space quotation marks again, and close your parentheses. And we'll copy this formula down. And we see that, again, Emerson and Jamie were the only one to receive a commission and an award. Now, sometimes you need to combine multiple if formulas to figure out your results. So in this case, we want to know the commission amount. The reason we need to combine the if formulas is because there's multiple breakpoints. At $40,000, they get one commission, 10%. At $50,000, they get 15%. So we need to somehow note that in Excel. So we're going to do equals if, and actually for the first one, I'm going to do an and. So we'll do and what we need is for cell D4, the dollar sold, to be greater than or equal to $40,000. Now the reason I did and is because we also need for D4 to be less than $50,000, right? Because $50,000 is a different price, is a different percent commission. So we close the parentheses, then comma, then we're actually going to type if again, because now we need to know what to do at the 50,000. So if cell D4 again is greater than or equal to $50,000. Oops, actually I missed something. So let me delete this for a minute. We're just going to delete that. We're going to go back to here. So again, greater than 40,000, less than 50,000. We want to say D4 times 0.10. Then we're going to type if, because now that's going to be, if this is not true, then move on to the next if formula. So at that point, we go back to D4, and now it needs to be greater than or equal to 50,000. So value if true will be, if it's $50,000 or more, will be D4 times 0.15. If it's not true, then we're just going to leave it at zero. Actually, I'm just going to type zero. We'll close our parentheses. Another parenthesis, which I didn't do, but Excel auto fixed it. So we see that this first commission, Jamie will receive $8,196 in commission. So I copy this down, copy the formulas, and you can see that she did receive 15% commission. Sasha received $4,600 in commission, and so on. And newbie, who had less than $40,000 in sales, didn't receive any commission. So I hope you found this video useful and that this helped walk you through the if formulas a little bit easier, helped to clarify them. If you like the video, please make sure to like it and to subscribe to the channel. So that way you'll be the first to know when any new videos come out. Thanks.